Hi, how is everyone doing? Today is Monday the 13th. We're still in February. I hope everybody had a blessed weekend. My week has been up and down. I am not feeling good again. I went to Winter Jam with my kids and a friend of ours on Friday. That night I end up getting fever and I have not been feeling good all weekend. So I am either battling a cold or I'm flu. I don't know what's going on. But I do thank God that, you know, my mom's out of the hospital. She's not in the hospital anymore, so she's feeling a lot better. And I think probably just going in and out of the hospital and, you know, trying to overdo myself, you know, kind of made me sick again. But I still give thanks and glory to God because, you know, every day is a blessing from Him. We are going to get through this with me trying not to sniff and all congested constantly because that's what's going on with me. We are going to try to get through our Bible study. We are on Psalms 20. And the thing with me is trying to make time for God. And that's really important because it's important to make time for God. And it's really hard with our daily life and our daily struggles getting, you know, kids ready for school, you know, washing clothes, doing, you know, dinner, you know, running to appointments and, you know, having someone sick in the family. It gets so hard to make time for God. But when we're going through all that, let's stop and let's try to always make time for God. And I've always tried to really, really encourage myself in doing that. And it's really hard because we get so caught up with our daily life that we just forget that we need to take time with God. And that's something that I am desperately really trying to work on because I find myself being so busy sometimes and not stopping and saying, oh, did I do my Bible study today? Did I give God the thanks today? Did I pray to God and tell Him thank Him for waking me up this morning? So, you know, I encourage everybody, you know, in that busy moment, you know, you're running the kids to school or making dinner, you know, all those things that you do, always strive to make time for God because He always strives to be there for us when we need Him. So that is something I wanted to really tell you today. That's what's been laying on my heart. That's what God's been laying on my heart is to really, really get me to spend more time with Him and study His Word and read His Bible. And that's what I want everybody else to do. Like I said, we're going to start in Psalms 20 today. I'm going to go over what we learned in Psalms 18 and a little what we learned in 19, which we learned that, you know, God is a rock, which David considered God as his rock, which a lot of us, we do. We consider God as our rock. We ask God for help, which David asks us for help. God answers us. God answers us in His best knowledge. He answers us what He thinks we deserve. We also learn that, you know, why God gives help to His people. We also learn that everything that David has, it came from God. So that's kind of what we get from everything that we have came from God. And then God made David king. As we learned in 18. And then, you know, in 19, we learned about, you know, our mind, how our mind works. Our mind doesn't always do the right thing. Our mind, you know, goes this way. Sometimes we're going to go this way. And we need to learn how to make sure we stay focused on God and learn that, you know, what our behaviors are and try to remember that we need to rely on God when we have those decisions in our brain and they're coming to us. And we need to remember to pray to Him and go to Him and ask for guidance and ask Him for help on any decisions that we have, on any decisions that we know that is going to be sinful, that we know that's not righteous, that we know that we should ask God about. So that's kind of what we learned in. And also we have been learning that David is running away from his enemies, that he is scared, that he went to go hide. And who did he rely on? He relied on God. He relied on God to help him. He went to God. He cried out to God. And, you know, he did feel lonely. He felt days that God wasn't listening, but God was never there. God never walked away from him. God is always with us. As I learned in church on Sunday, when I was there, you know, God will never forsake us. remember that. God will never forsake us. God is always there with us. Even though the days that we seem so bad and it seems like, oh goodness, he's not here for us, he's always there. You know, I take my situation, for example, you know, I'm trying my best to do the right thing. I went to the hospital every day to see my mom, make sure she was fine, make sure she was healthy, keeping track of her. And, you know, in the process, you know, going in and out of the hospital and doing all those things, I end up getting a little sick myself. But at the same time, I trust and believe God that he has a reason for everything. And he's not going to put much on me that I can't bear. And he knows that I'm a strong person and I always trust and believe in him. I'll stop mumbling on because, you know, it's just that I haven't talked to y'all for so long. It seems like it's been weeks since I came and spoke to you guys. And I'm going to say a prayer and, you know, we'll get started in Psalms 20 and we'll read that and we'll go over a little bit of, you know, what God is telling us. And, hold on a second. I'm going to go get some tissue. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, so let me start by a prayer and then we'll get started on studying Psalms 20. Dear Lord, I thank you for blessing us to see another day. I thank you for, you know, continuing to let me teach others and show the love and the caring that you do so much for everybody. And I want all the listeners to see through me that God can change you. God can help make your life better. Just bring him into your life and it's so much joy. I want to thank God for his word. I want to thank him for, you know, just his spirit inside of me and making me feel joyful and making me be able to understand and try to get y'all to understand. God, as I read your words today, give me that spirit. Give me your Holy Spirit. Guide me and teach me what you want me to say. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so I'm going to get this Bible app to read it for us, which we always have complications with. Hopefully we shouldn't. I'm getting this together slowly but surely. And we're going to go over this and we're going to find out what God is trying to tell us today.
Psalm 20. The Lord hear thee in the day of trouble. The name of the God of Jacob defend thee. Send thee help from the sanctuary and strengthen thee out of Zion. Remember all thy offerings and accept thy burnt sacrifice, Selah. Grant thee according to thine own heart and fulfill all thy counsel. We will rejoice in thy salvation, and in the name of our God we will set up our banners. The Lord fulfill all thy petitions. Now know I that the Lord saveth his anointed. He will hear him from his holy heaven with the saving strength of his right hand. Some trust in chariots, and some in horses. But we will remember the name of the Lord our God. They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and stand upright. Save, Lord, let the King hear us when we call.
Okay. As it said in verse 1, it says, the Lord hear thee in the day of trouble, the name of God of Jacob, and defend us. So, pretty much when I went on here for it to study this, to tell us what this is about, I'm going to read this. It says, Jesus, we are going to Jerusalem. There will kill the Son of Man, but 3 days later he will come to life again. Matthew 20:18. The Son of Man was a name that Jesus used for himself. This is a Psalms of David of a music leader. And it says on here, verses 1 through 3, we are praying that the Lord will answer you when trouble comes. The name of God of Jacob will make you safe. God will send you help from his holy place. He will make you strong from Zion. God will remember all your gifts. He will like all your burnt offerings. Verse 4. We want God to give you all that you really want to make all your plans work well. We will shout for joy when you win the war. We will lift up our banners in the name of our God. We want the Lord to answer all that you pray. Now I know the Lord will save his king. God will answer him from his holy heaven. The right hand of God will save the king. Some people rely on chariots, others rely on horses, but we will trust in the name of the Lord our God. They will falter and fall, but we will get up and remain strong. Lord, save the king. Answer us when we pray. And out here it says burnt offering. It's an animal that is killed, a burnt offering. Banners is a long piece of material, which I'm sure everybody knows that. Relay is another word for trust. Chariot is a car, a soldier used our horses to pull. And falter is a walk badly or perhaps a fall over. And when I go in here and I read what they show in here for the devotions, it talks a lot in here. It says, although all of our nation's military effects are necessary, when will America's made beloved country follow verses 7 and 8 in complete trust in God for our protection? We as Christians will rejoice in thy salvation in the name of our God. We will set up our banners. The Lord fulfill all the petitions. Excuse me. Now know that the Lord saveth the united. He will hear him from holy heaven with the saving strength of his right hand. Putting your total trust in the Lord will give you peace and resurrection that no governmental plan can. Trust him totally today, for only he knows what tomorrow holds for individually and as a nation. This is going to be a touchy thing that, you know, I'm probably going to get into, but right now, in our world today, we are totally trusting on government. Not everybody. I'm not going to say everybody's totally trusting on government, but everybody's trusting on the government, on the president, on everything to make the world better. Yes, God put them there. God knows everything that's going to happen. But we also have to remember that God is king, that he's the one that Jesus Christ died for our sins. So he's in control of everything. He sits in the right hand of God. So we should be putting our trust in God, not our government. We should put trust that God knows what he's doing. And not everybody looks at it like that. I look at it like that because, you know, I see who our president is. I'm not judgmental. That's not me. I'm not going to go and say, hey, you know, I'm a person that believes that anybody can change. Anybody can do something if they put their mind to it. You know, I can't tell you what he's going to do and what he's not going to do. I can't tell you any of those things because I don't know him. I don't know him personally. And people that I do know personally still make mistakes. So, and you can't trust the government. I mean, you know, the government lies all the time. People lie all the time. So you don't trust that. Who should we trust? We trust God. It's all in the Bible. There's no way that we should not trust him. So what I'm getting at is, like it says, seven and eight, completely trust in God and the protection. It says some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we will remember the name of the Lord our God. They are brought down and fallen, but we are risen and standing upright. And the last verse, save Lord, let the king hear us when we call. So I say as a nation, I say as the world, I say as now is what we're going through, the best thing to do is to pray. Get on your knees, ask God to help the world. If we come together as a nation, we come together as churches, and we teach God's truth, and we use that to fight with, I think there's so much more that we can gain out of it. And that's the problem with the war day. They're trying to take God out when we need God in. You know, we need God in so much stuff. You know, we need God in our families. We need God. We need churches, you know, to preach the right thing about God. And like I said, I'm not trying to be judgmental. I'm going by God's truth. I'm going by what God says in the Bible. And I'm going by what it says right here. Put your total trust in the Lord. Put your total trust in the Lord. We'll give you a peace and a assurance that no governmental plan can. So, any government plan or anything that comes up that, you know, that's trying to do, let's pray. And let's pray that he took whatever. They went to God and they prayed to ask, okay, is this how we should do this? Is this how we should do this? Is this how we should do this? Because, like I said, I think you should pray before you make a decision. You know, I think that's how it should work. You know, pray when you go spend this money on a brand new car. Pray when you get ready to go get a house, you know. I think our president should pray on some of the decisions, you know, not on some. I think on all of them he should pray on the decisions that he makes, you know. Go to God and ask God, God, how do you want the country ran? How should I make it run, you know? We shouldn't be getting rid of religion. We shouldn't be punishing people that are religious and that have a belief. You shouldn't do that. So, and like I said, this is a really touchy subject. There's a lot of things we could go over in this subject about the government plan, you know, because that's kind of what it's going on, you know, because I know there's a lot of people that are doing a lot of things right now because of the president that's in office and they don't like the decision. But you can't really have a say-so if you didn't vote, if you didn't really take the time out. But, you know, a lot of people feel that, you know, if they did vote, their vote didn't count anyways. So there's a lot of things right there. As I said, this is a very touchy subject, and I'm not trying to make anybody feel any way. Everybody has a right to their decision. And I think praying is the key. Pray before you decide to do anything. All the riots and everything that's going on right now, peaceful riots are fine. You know, if you're going to have a riot, it's going to be peaceful. It's not going to start drama. It's not going to do anything. Fine. But if you're going to go out there and you're going to start drama and you're going to start hurting people, you don't need to do it. You know? And if you look at the Bible back then and you look at the world now, you can see a lot of things that happen. That happened back then. The only thing now, we have technology, we have cell phones, you know. It's, you know, everything's just a little bit different. We don't have carriages. We don't have stuff that carries by horse, not where I, you know. So, you know, there's a lot of things here that it's just about trusting and believing God, you know, especially in the situation and the times that we are now. Like I told you again, God will not forsake us. God is with us. God is always with us. God gave his only son, Jesus Christ, for our sins. So, you know, if we repent and we go to him and we ask God for forgiveness, you know, we are a child of God, you know. And I pray for all my listeners, you know, to find you a good church. You know, read your Bible on a daily basis. Like I said, make time for him. And, you know, like it says in here, you know, put your total trust in the Lord. Put your total trust in the Lord. You might not like the president. Put your total trust in the Lord. You might not like what your government's doing right now, but put your trust in the Lord. You know, the Lord can move mountains. Your prayer can move mountains. You know, if we just pray and we come together as a community and we learn how to trust and believe in God and, you know, stop fighting and arguing about the things that we know we can't change. The only way we can change it, if we go to God and we pray and we ask. We have not because we ask not. And we don't have enough people asking. We have more people pulling it back doing wrong and instead of people doing right. So let's come together as a community. Let's come together in love and support and caring. And let's learn how to pray together. Let's learn how to go to a good church. You know, let's learn how to read our Bible. Let's go back and let's find God again. Because what we don't realize, Jesus is coming back soon. And what side do you want to be on? I would rather, where I know I'm going, is to go and be with Jesus, to go and be with God. I'm going to heaven. And I strive for everybody else to find that love, find that caring. Because, I mean, knowing God does not bring anything bad. It brings nothing but joy. I might have problems in my life, but I'm very, very joyful. I'm very, very thankful. I might be sick right now, but I am so thankful. I am so thankful because there's nothing that God has not done for me. He's done so much for me. So I hope that pretty much out of this lesson is pretty much trusting God. Like I said, putting your total trust in the Lord will give you a peace of assurance that no governmental plan can. Trust Him totally today, for only He knows what tomorrow holds for us and individually as a country. So that, please take that with y'all today. Take that with y'all to understand that that's what He's trying to tell us. And closing here at the end, it says, thank you, Lord, for protecting us each day. Thank you for hearing us in the day of trouble and defeating us. Help us to remember the name of the Lord, our God, today and every day. So I hope that you take away from this, with all the stuff that's going on in the world right now, you know, pray for our president. Pray for our government. You know, pray for that. Pray for God to do His will. Pray for that He does what He wants to do. Pray that they listen to God, what God is telling them to do. But never, never, if they're not doing the right thing, you continue to do the right thing. You do the right thing that God's telling you to do. Never stop doing what God is telling you to do. That's what I hope that y'all took out of this today. I'm going to say a word of prayer, and I hope y'all have a blessed day. I hope y'all have a blessed Tuesday. I will be going to the doctor tomorrow to find out why I keep getting sick off and on. And I also have class tomorrow because I have to do a test tomorrow. So please keep me in your prayer when I do my post-test tomorrow to go try to get my high school diploma still. And also want to tell y'all to please keep my family and my mother still in prayers. Like, we're all still going through this cold. We're all still getting sick, and it's just passing around. And I'm going to pray for everybody, and I hope y'all have a blessed day. Dear God, thank you for the lesson today. I pray for our president. I pray for our government, God. You know the situation, and you know what's going on right now. You know the things that we need, and you know the things that we don't need. God, lift up our president and lift up our government, and just lift up the people around the world to start going to you and start trusting you and start believing you and know that you will not forsake them. God, as we come to you today in this Bible study, I thank you for the lesson, and I thank you for letting us know to trust you always in no matter circumstances. And lift up my listeners and pray for them and give them a heart to want to follow you and to go to you and remember that Jesus Christ will forgive them for their sins. I hope everybody has a blessed day. Thank you, God, for your lesson. And thank you for everything you do for us. In Jesus' name, amen.